legs is going to be most important for the power he brings. Here we go. And quick right back down the line. It's the step around that we talked about.
Just to answer your question in a better way, I think that right there, baiting Zhang Wujin, because he chases his forehand. So if you can get him in there, maybe you can take him out on the other side. If you're Liang.
Yeah, I think also obviously that would force Zhang Wujin, if that happens too many times, to rely on his backhand a little bit more. And in the backhand-to-backhand battle, to me, Liang Jingkun is the better prepared, better equipped.
Love, three.
Years since these two have faced. Flawless start so far for Liang Jingkun. Look at this one. A blink of an eye and it's gone.
Looking to make a statement, Liang Jingkun, returning from the ban. Won his last event, not including the Singapore Smash, of course.
Five, love.
Zhang Wujin looking for some answers here. In terms of the long push, very decisive there for Liang Jingkun.
Love, Jake.
This is incredible. For me, Adam, Liang Jingkun might just have the best touch play in the world.
The best touch play?
Yeah.
Well, I definitely agree that his touch is outstanding. A lot of incredible touch players out there.
One, six.
First point on the scoreboard here, Zhang Wujin with the serve. It's always interesting to see the rotation. We'll have plenty of exciting replays for you throughout the match.
Six,
good deception
two.
There as he sort of fades across that ball.
Beautiful. Yeah, disguised with the shoulders, didn't he? Had the open racket face. That was right in the corner.
Yeah, tough to tell where he's going to go there. Two in a row here for Zhang Wujin. And this time inside the baseline, taking advantage of a small opportunity there, limited time opportunity.
Did the Dima touch, the backhand touch, more towards the forehand side.
You're hiding the ball. 6-3.
So the ball must be visible to the receiver at all times. This is actually one of the most common uncalled service faults that there is, the ball falling behind the head. Ooh.
4-6.
Which is a fairly natural thing, especially with taller players. They toss the ball and then they lean in to serve, but the ball disappears on the way down. So the crowd getting behind Liang Jingkun here after 4 points in a row for Zhang Wujin.
Oh. 4-6.
Would have been interesting with the cameras right there. Had it hit the net and hit the cameras, then come in, still would have been a let serve. Look at the forehands out here. The power is coming out. This has been a seesaw start of a match.
Literally. Can you imagine if he wins his point again? First six to Liang, second six to Zhang. It's not often you see something like that, but let's see.
I can imagine. He's made it quite easy to imagine. Oh, but just like the first point, a little bit behind the table, Liang Jingkun handcuffing him, saying, I'll let you take that forehand, but it's going to have to be from deep. You're going to have to lean for it, which creates the opening on the other side.
And there's the trap. But still, I mean, Zhang played a brilliant forehand there.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy to think about what the options are there once you commit to playing that forehand.
7-6.
Backhand inside the table, aggressive wherever he can be to keep Liang Jingkun off the attack.
This is a massive potential momentum swing.
I mean, if you see it on screen there, 7 of the last 8 points, there's already been quite a swing.
8-7.
If Zhang steals this game, and Liang, knowing he was 6-0 up, could be a tough cobweb to sweep.
Yeah, definitely some star power in that story, the scoreline. So unusual. You could see him there. He was there early, Liang Jingkun, but the options seemed limited. Better response this time around. Goes in, uses the forehand. so that he's in better position after the touch play.
Came off surprisingly slow. Yeah, that's lovely. He wasn't in the best position. He wasn't fully behind the ball there.
For the backhand?
Yeah.
This is actually one of the strengths for me of Liang Jingqun. One thing that him and Fan Zhendong have in common, that they just have such a big sweet spot, if you will, meaning region on the backhand side, an area where they can generate a lot of power. It doesn't have to be just in a perfect place for them.
Beautifully said.
Thanks. I mean, it looked like we were watching a jib there, just replaying this unusually high-arcing spin shot loaded with spin. Look at the racket there. Zhang Wujing going nearly behind the head like Ma Lin and Quadri Aruna. And Liang Jingqun was able to keep the ball down, stay on top of it consistently.
Good from Zhang, though. But brilliant containing there from Liang. Recommended, isn't it, to play with a lot of spin when the further you are away from the table.
I guess it's a case-by-case basis, but you can understand why it could be helpful. 9 points apiece here. Ooh, and a long reverse pendulum serve with sided topspin here. Liang Jingqun with a wry smile, and it is game point to the player who was down 0-6. I mean, it was looking like a complete wipeout the first towel break. Game point to Korea's Zhang Wujin. Beautiful receive here. Zhang Wujin tries to change it up and go to the forehand side, but right at the baseline, it's Liang Jingqun.
Got a taste of Chinatown there. I mean, that's what happens if your serve drifts an inch too long. Easy pickings for Liang.
So here we are, deuce alternating serves. Tough way to start again. Push comes a little bit loose. Good play from Liang Jingqun to earn this ball. All starts with the serve, well placed, and Zhang Wujin not able to get aggressive on the receive. So game point to Liang Jingqun now, after saving one. Oh my goodness, a little bit off the top of the net in that counter, but from the backhand corner, Zhang Wujin able to go shot for shot. Here it is, the big forehand comes in, bend, and he turns it right around to play it down the line.
The first one that he played out the middle was the most impressive one for me, even more so than the finisher. Don't know how he makes space for that, it's just amazing.
Now this was a very interesting sort of game of chicken, where they were both saying, I want to wait and see if you're going to turn. Let's go backhand to backhand for a minute, and it's Zhang Wujin who takes the opportunity and really explodes on that first big forehand. Game point once again for Zhang Wujin. Down the line as fast as the feet are, Zhang Wujin is going to have a lot of ground to cover. See how the side spin involved in this rally from the start. Funny, when someone's behind the table, you don't usually see them go to the forehand unless they think they can hit it out of reach, because it's much easier for the opponent to counter from far back with the forehand than the backhand. That said, Liang Jingqun took his chances, and it paid off. Strong opening backhand and the forehand to follow. Another game point, what, third time over here?
Yeah.
Zhang Wujin.
Let's see if third time's a charm.
Hey. I mean, we've heard it our whole life, so it better be, right? What an unusual serve. We'll see how he does here this week.
I'm waiting for his match against Felix Lebrun. But back to this. It's an interesting one, right? Cheat point for Liang. Zhang knows it. Wang Hao, three-time Olympic singles finalist. Never won it, but was world champion too.
love.
So the start hasn't been a problem so far for Liang Jingquan. Took the first 6 points of last game, and still, Zhang Wujin found a way to secure the game. Forehand is so clean. It's tough to imagine if you're not playing competitively how much spin, even if you are playing competitively, how much spin is on the ball. But after that ball hit the net, it crawled right back into the net. Beautiful free backhand here.
Yeah, and it was all set up by that mid-distance touch. The question zone. What do I do against it? Is it long enough to attack? Is it short enough to touch back?
The head as well, same warning for both players. In all fairness, this could probably be issued to most players. Nice adjustment though. You have to wonder, these subtle variations in serve. Zhang Wujin did everything he needed to sort of honor the warning there. You could see the serve was just a little bit farther away from his body. But you also wonder if that breaks sort of his rhythm and what he's used to and gets the serve just loose enough that Liang Jingquan can do what he did.
I think that was a big factor in that, personally.
6-1.
Now he's playing into this again. Down the line switch is very good. And maybe we're reaching that point, Adam, like you say, where Zhang Wujin may have to open up a little bit more with his backhand.
One, seven.
I think surprise, this is one of the key factors at this level. If the opponent knows what's coming, they can handle anything, just about. A long push especially.
One, eight.
Looking for answers, but not finding a lot right now. Liang Jingquan, even a better start than in game one. See the idea there.
9-1.
The touch that you talked about, you complimented earlier, those soft hands.
So good. So good.
Dead. One.
Tight side spin serve there, pushed back into the net. It is 9 game points, Liang Jingquan. Ooh, a chop block from Zhang Wujin, and then a tomahawk chop there in the end after the net ball. Liang Jingquan showing some of that touch as well. High backhands aren't easy. Generally, if the ball's a little bit higher, obviously more options for the attacking player.
3-10.
So a few steps in the right direction, but long road ahead for Zhang Wujin.
3-10.
There it is, the touch play. It's Liang Jingquan to secure game number two. In control based on the last game and current momentum, Liang Jingquan.
One,
and a tight serve again. Very subtle there, that pendulum serve with the spin on it. It's mostly side spin, but just enough topspin to get that third ball. Zhang Wujin's cleaning up.
Love, two.
Beautiful point construction there from Liang. Into the backhand and then to the open space, yeah.
Just another example of how big, I don't even know if I'd call that a sweet spot. It was really defense, but he got his racket out and blocked it back from so wide, and he's had 6 of the last 8 points.
One, two.
Better from John there. Spinny open up. Bit of resentment, I think, Liang Jingquan towards Zhang Wujin.
Why is that?
Just because, I mean, they denied him the career open final, and as juniors, he denied him big titles as well.
3-1.
It's funny, we heard a little vocalization there. Zhang Wujin is regarded on the Korean team as the funniest player on the team. They all say, oh, he's just ridiculous. He's such a clown. He's so funny. And it's true. He's a hilarious guy. That said, with a great sense of humor, I think, comes a great sense of passion, and he is a fighter. You might recall some of the scaffolds or complications with Zhang Jike Two times, I think, he beat him in the same event. Not so many players could say that they had done that during Zhang Jike's prime. Zhang Wujin down by one.
2-4.
It's amazing now that Zhang Wujin is already 27 years old. I mean, we watched him as a junior world champion and in his young 20s breaking into the adult game. 2018, as mentioned, Korea triple crown, including that win in the final over this man here, Leung Jin Kwin.
4-0.
Nice misdirection here with that parallel forehand flick.
Just for some context, Leung Jin Kwin has played a non-Chinese player 155 times and won 133 of them.
5-3.
Is that mid 80% or so?
Yeah, 86.
Jeez. That's part of the reason he's one of the most dependable Chinese national team players currently.
100%. I mean, last two world championships as well, bronze medal in both.
If I'm not mistaken, he's the reason you didn't see Fan Zhendong in 2019's final.
Yeah, yeah.
This is always so difficult. When you leave the ball, I mean, it's difficult for Leung Jin Kwin to play this ball from off the forehand side of the table under. Watch this, that position there. But he spins it to the short side and he plays it very shallow. That means the ball stays very low.
4-7.
Back in control in the driver's seat here. It feels like Leung Jin Kwin is sort of dictating the points.
Yeah, he's making it so hard for Zhang Wujin to play a confident forehand.
That receive, even just a few centimeters there on the back of the table, it's enough.
7.
Good combination here from Zhang Wujin. Gets a bit of a balance shift there from Leung Jin Kwin, so when he goes to the backhand, he's only on 1 foot. Yeah, that reach all the way across. Had to backpedal quite a bit. You hungry?
Kinda.
What were you thinking?
I need to see more table tennis though.
Oh good, yeah, my appetite is, I'm loving it. Main course right here, right now. We've got more main courses to follow.
6-8.
Feels badly done by Zhang Wujin there. Got a chance though with two serves to level things up.
Now this serve is nice. If you've got top and side spin and it's still short, the fact that it was played to the forehand side here, oh, this is where the players and the coaches sit. Li Sun there for the women of Team China as Leung Jin Kwin.
9-7.
Now that is surprising. What are you thinking?
I think that the fact it was a let there made Zhang Wujin second guess going for the serve again. But he decided to, and I think he then had an effect on him mentally with his third ball attack.
9-8.
Either way, it did look to be a clever push, an emptier, longer push, meaning less rotation, so the Zhang Wujin would lift up and out, but that was the point before last. Zhang Wujin here with a successful point, climbing his way back into this game.
9-8.
Bit of tension in the net and the crowd here after that serve. 9-8. A lot of work for that touch shot. Zhang Wujin receives that just right.
And now he has the serves.
One more time there. Soft touch. Again, if you're playing table tennis, and the follow-up is just beautiful. I was going to say, if you're playing table tennis and you want to learn how to play shorter receives in those tough moments, loosen up the grip of the racket. Here we go, 9 points each. Going back to it, what, three in a row now?
Yeah. Could it have the same effect as it did last time?
Oh, Oh, top of the net here. Dong Woojin with a saving grace from behind the table. That backhand effort, just whatever he could do to get it back.
It's rapid, isn't it?
It's crazy to me that Liang Jingqun is able to make such a strong attack on that receive. Again, it's a finger-breaking serve. Game point, Zhang Wujin.
Wow.
That he's gone for that serve so many times in a row.
And the let as well, before each one.
Right. Oh, man, I was wondering when he would pull that out. Something fast and long to the backhand side. Liu Dingshuo and Yu Ziyang there. Discussing that serve, side topspin. Liang Jingqun very well prepared, didn't fall for it, and stays in position to open up the cross court. So much like game one, alternating serves here until one player has a two-point lead.
10-11.
I mean, it's been so back and forth. Zhang Wujin was chasing for a good portion of this game. Timeout was already spent by Liang Jingqun. At his back against the ropes and now sitting on a game point on the receive, Liang Jingqun.
Leg. 10, 11.
It just goes to show you how tight and how well practiced these serves are. This is incredibly unusual. I felt like immediately Zhang Wujin was in hot water when he didn't take the third ball attack.
This is a very similar situation to Alexi Lebrun versus Liang Jingqun. When Liang had the match point, he got passive when it looked like he was in the driving seat, and it was a very similar rally, actually.
So game point saved by Zhang Wujin, serve back to Liang Jingqun. Short side of the table on the step around. This is where the agility and that twisting ability really comes out from Zhang Wujin to hug this ball and play it down the line. Watch this. It's a lot of work for a point. Just for one shot. Game point back to Zhang Wujin. Well, it's going to be at least as high scoring as it was in game number one. Fourth towel break, and the only score possible for a fourth towel break. In case you're curious what they were chanting, it's Chinese team. Let's go, Jiao. Zhongguo Dui, Jiao. Short side again, but he's ready to cover that cross court. It's all the touch, that receive where he takes all the pace off. And now it's a timeout on Zhang Wujin's side, who's not from China. Oh, he changed it up. He pulled out a pendulum serve short. Liang Jingqun perfectly prepared, opens up aggressively. The timeout has been diffused so far.
Never looked in doubt, did he, Liang there? Incredible composure.
I love it. The game of hot potato. Both players trying to touch it just softly and shortly enough that the opponent can't get the opening attack. That's as many pushes in a row as we've seen from these two that I can recall in this match. Be gone, ball. I've had enough of you. And now it is game point for Liang Jingqun on the receive once again. And he takes care of business. A big win here, 15-13, Liang Jingqun. But he's down 1-2.
Love one.
It's always tough from the baseline to keep the ball just behind the net. For the ball to travel that great of a distance and still stay short, quite unlikely.
One all.
And we see players in the touch game using that cross-court shot a bit more, partially because it's the length of the table, meaning you can use the table as an obstacle for your opponent a bit easier with greater margin for error. One, smart play, two. That wrap around to keep it down the line, quite tricky.
Yeah, so hard. And this is the benefit of doing a regular exercise training.
For those that aren't into table tennis, obviously welcome if you're newer to table tennis, but just to clarify for some people who might not spend a lot of time in the training hall, when you say irregular training, can you elaborate on that?
So randomized. Instead of doing two backhands, two forehands, you might do anywhere into a certain point of the table.
3-2.
Just to help kind of create that ability to adapt to more realistic match type situations.
Right.
3-all.
It's interesting. Players, you know, Timo Boll, even in his mid-30s, would say in terms of training, don't train so much anymore. It's mostly just playing some matches. Stay fresh. You know, he's been riding bikes for a long time. He doesn't forget how to keep his balance there. It's just the gameplay when people are really pulling out the tactics. That's what he needs.
4-3.
Good steal from the back of the table. Liang Jingquan just inside that baseline. Once again, successful. What are you thinking?
So free-flowing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Different to some other Chinese players. And I know every player is different, but I think Liang's is quite different. The arm seems a little bit more free. Doesn't seem to come forward as much with the body at the exact same time. Like Ma Long's, for example.
5-4.
I think also the appearance of Liang Jingquan can be quite deceiving. You look at this guy, you're like, he's massive. This guy must be tight, but he's agile and loose. He's the guy that you're like, what? You're the most flexible guy? You're the most flexible guy in this yoga class?
Oh.
5-all.
I'll take it.
Back edge of the table. It's funny, I heard it, and then I looked and saw Liang Jingquan's hand sort of hesitantly waiting to apologize. I think he was waiting for Zhang Wujin to look back his way, make sure that his message was received.
Six, five.
Not easy to find the middle of Zhang Wujin, but he did it.
And he did it from the middle, too, which is even more impressive. This is another example where someone not only dodges a bullet, but dishes their own out in the process.
Six, all.
Good quick read of that long push. Zhang Wujin getting the feet into position quickly.
That was the biggest rip I think we've seen of Zhang Wujin's backhand on the third ball, and it was answered.
Yeah, Liang Jingquan very quick with that racket high. It's funny to see the coaches and the players with the big screen in the middle when they recognize they're on it.
8-6.
These tight moments here, and it's Liang Jingquan inside the table, keeping it uncomfortable for Zhang Wujin. His variation in the spin game, we know he's got the power. Sometimes he slows it down just a little bit and invests more in the spin.
Spreading it around stunningly. Forehand-wise, they've been so similar. But I think Liang's backhand especially has been a big difference maker between these two.
Right. From the start of the match, we knew that Liang Jingquan in the backhand-to-backhand battle should be the higher percentage winner. 2 points away from moving on. And when the forehand's not coming down as well, it's credit to Liang Jingquan for pinning that middle and rushing Zhang Wujin to step around. 4 match points for a player who is very close to being down 1-2. And there it is. It is Liang Jingquan on to the round of 16 through Zhang Wujin for the first time in his career.